Hey guys, what's up? How's it going? We are back and I'm in Iceland! I'm at Skógafoss, if I'm saying that correctly. I could be very, very wrong. And to say I'm surprised at how big it is probably the biggest understatement in the world. Like, looking at it right now, what in the world? This is just from the car. What?
Life is a winding road, no telling where it goes. Driving
Tell me this isn't the craziest thing you've ever seen.
And I really want to know.
Also, am I getting soaked right now? Yes. Do I care? No. Like, what?
Where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs.
Look, I don't know if y'all heard me in there because it's so loud, but this place is awesome. Like, I'm soaking wet. I don't even care. I'm happy as a clam. My camera's soaked. Should be fine. I don't know. Overall, so stoked about that experience. Like, if you haven't already, make sure to go follow me on Instagram, because I think I just got some pretty cool photos. Like, how can you get a rainbow at this place? I mean, that's just me. I feel like I haven't seen that many photos with rainbows. I don't know. Also, additional information, you can take some stairs all the way to the top. I'm not doing that, but you can get in from the top view too.
And I really wanna know, really wanna
stop. I don't know what today, but beautiful.
Let's figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky is falling down.
This is bananas, oh my god. Cool. I'm soaked. I'm absolutely
soaked, but again, don't care. How cool. Even if the sky is falling down. Even if the sky is falling down.
Well guys, I don't know what the name of that waterfall is. I can't say it, but I'm gonna tell you. It is probably the coolest waterfall experience so far, like hands down, and technically my last one because I leave tomorrow. So 10 out of 10, recommend that one. So cool, and be prepared to get soaked. Be smarter than I am and bring a bag for your camera though. Mine's a little wet, I'm air drying it right now. Should be fine, but still. Alright, I made the very last second impulsive decision to hike the volcano today instead of tomorrow, and tomorrow's the day that I leave, so hopefully it's visible. Right now it looks kind of foggy, but somebody did tell me it was visible, and it's just supposed to be raining from here until the time I leave, so I think my chances are just as good today as they are tomorrow. So here we go. I'm gonna try and make it quick though. 3 miles up, 3 miles down. Here we go. I don't know if you guys can hear that, but I feel like I can hear the lava. I just can't see it. Oh my god. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Thank you. guys.
Made it. It's cloudy and I can see it in the spurts back there. I'm gonna shut it. But holy cow. I don't even have words for this. What is it possible?
Lava fields are massive, like they just keep going and going and going and going and going. Like I really can't understand how much lava had to be coming out for the lava to get that far. Like, so crazy, so cool. Maybe one day I'll get to experience something like that in my life. I don't know, but this was so much to me, so much. Well guys, I made it, and that might have been one of, if not the most insane things I've ever done in my life. For a lot of reasons, but I'll talk about that here in a second. Okay, you guys, I know I said that I was gonna like get in the car and talk to you guys a little bit more about what was going on, but I just didn't, and we will talk about that in a second. But I wanted to kind of give you a little bit of a recap of things that was happening like behind, that were happening behind the scenes that I wasn't talking about. So going into this hike, I last second decided to do it because I got there, I was scouting the parking lot because I was gonna get up and do it for sunrise, like before the sun came up, so I could see the lava in the dark. And I got there and there were people everywhere and they were saying it was visible. And then looking up, there was a cloud on the mountain. So I was like, I don't know how. So I just went for it. And I thought that I was gonna be much closer to the volcano, and I was not. It was a much farther hike than I thought. And thankfully, I'm somebody, when I travel solo, I eavesdrop on other people's conversations. Excuse me, there's a little bit of a burp in there. I eavesdrop on other people's conversations, and I thankfully heard a group of people who had like a friendly guide, somebody they knew that was guiding them to this hike, who had done it a million times, say that it was like another 3 miles on top of the mile that I already did to get to the flowing lava. And I was like, oh, okay. So I just kept following this group, and thankfully I ended up where I did and I got to see it, and it was a beautiful experience. There were tons of people up there. Like, even if you're doing this alone, like, you're not gonna be alone up there. There's so many people. There's camps up there, there's antennas, there's all sorts of stuff watching this volcano. So there's always somebody up there. And then I sat up there for hours and hours and hours. And by the time I was leaving, the sun was down, it was dark, as you guys saw. And I was just like following a group of people. I saw a group of like 15 people. I didn't even think it was a tour guide, and it ended up being a tour group. And I was talking to some of the people, and the tour guide ended up getting so mad because he was doing a head count, and I was like, oh, I'm not in the group. And he made a very like rude comment towards me about knowing I wasn't in the group. So I left the group and promptly had to follow people who weren't really sure where they were going down. And I'm pretty sure I knew where I was, but again, it was dark, so I was a little nervous, and I knew there were a bunch of different trailheads. So keep all of this in mind if you're going to do it in the dark and if you're going to do it alone. There are multiple trailheads to get to different parts of viewing volcano, and I just went with the super easy one. I just wanted to see it. I didn't need anything super special. So keep all of those things in mind. I know that's kind of a lot of information and extends this video a little bit, but I do hope that's helpful for anyone who's going to check out this volcano. You do have to pay to park, and you pay via an app. Just pay for it. It's somebody's land, and they're just requesting that you guys pay to park there and go look at the volcano. So Anyway, all of that aside, after this was all done and I was soaking it all in and I got into the car and I made it to my campsite, I realized that I still had a full day in Iceland. I somehow goofed days and that's why so many things got cut out. That's why I felt like I was driving so much, which I did, so keep that in mind too. But I goofed up my schedule a little bit, but that gave me the opportunity to go to the Sky Lagoon, which is what I did, and that video will be coming next week and my thoughts on all of that. So please be sure to subscribe. That's kind of all I'm gonna say for this video. If you guys have any questions about any of this, anything from the last couple vlogs about Iceland or travel in general, whatever, please just leave your questions below. I do my best to get back to all of them, and I really appreciate you guys, and I'm so excited for the next adventure. So I will see you there. Bye.